have any questions about Driveway Theater Project, we do take donations for the project. That's how we pay our actors. That's how we pay for equipment, for process equipment, obviously. But the equipment we normally use for these. And also, if you want to host one, these are completely free. If you want to do one of these, we have a nice, we have a sweet little menu. We've got Maltese Falcon, it's a radio play. We've got some scenes from Shakespeare. We're currently bringing complete works of Shakespeare back up, which was what we used to test the failure last year, and it went over like gangbusters. Incredibly boisterous and funny. We also have Blacademics. We are working on some education stuff with a conversation between Frederick Douglass and Captain John Brown, and we've got check leaves, and then there's always something in the works. So if you're curious about this whole Driveway Theater Project, please come see me after the show. I'd love talking about it, so now I'm going to get off the stage.
Enjoy the show, and we hope you think about it after as well. Okay.
And then after a while, it just said, Negro, what in the hell are you doing out here? You ain't got no business being out here. So sorry. All over the middle of nowhere, I thought, the hills have eyes, or that somebody was gonna pop out somewhere.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you're here now, okay? Mm-hmm. You are here now. And this is Georgia.
How about a seat?
What?
From my hands.
From your hands.
Oh, it's a delicious medley of seeds.
They are really good. Oh, no, thank you. I don't want to. It's just
try one.
It's from your hand.
No, not to worry. The chef makes sure that I wash my hands thoroughly in a brine of sea salt and lemon juice, rice filtered water, and lavender oil. My hands are the cleanest they can be.
Act like you've been somewhere. Just one.
Trust me, I don't want more. I mean, yeah, it's a little salty, but
I'll get your table.
This is it?
Yeah.
Are they even open?
Of course, and they have been expecting us. I didn't have to call ahead or anything. They just.
Is this one of those type of places where the gimmick is to be rude to you on purpose?
That's just stunt convention. Yes, they are breaking with the traditional conventions of the restaurant is the place where one makes demands, but rather a venue for an entire experience. An experience that asks the diner to just let go and be taken on a journey.
But there is food coming at some point, right? Because I didn't drive all the way out here just to start.
Good evening, ladies. My name is Georgia, G-E-O-R-G-I-A, like my name tag. We do a prefix menu here, so you don't worry about a thing. Just let us do the driving, okay?
Well, I have a food restriction.
No.
No. My nutritionist
she
has me on a
food. Trust me, I can come back.
Not have to come back. My friend Rochelle here is going to be a good guest and trust the host, right? Fine. I was
great.
Just be- Let this happen, Rochelle.
Okay.
You cannot be so resistant. Something, huh? We're within 7 or 8 miles of one another, but had to drive all the way out of town to finally sit down together.
Yeah.
Haven't seen you in a while.
Oh, it's been a minute.
Keith's party!
Oh, I wasn't invited to Keith's party.
Well, I know I saw you there.
Was it me?
Risha, we the only two black women over 21 within a 150-mile radius of this area. I know I saw you at Keith's party.
I don't know, maybe.
Yeah, it has been a while.
It has been a busy time.
I know it.
Oh, I have been swamped.
Girl, me too.
State universities don't play when it comes to that workload.
Now, liberal arts colleges are no joke either.
Well,
what?
I mean,
they work me. They do.
Well, yeah, but you got all sorts of latitude. Low class size, plus your students are kind of masochists when it comes to homework. I got to practically drive mine.
Let's not go comparing.
Was I comparing?
Yes, you just did. You just compared our students.
I didn't realize I was doing that.
We both work hard.
Girl, I know. I wasn't.
All good. I know.
I still don't think I was comparing.
Oh, I don't care. I am glad that you could join me. And I'm sorry that we couldn't drive together. I had to rush from campus and run a couple of errands.
Okay.
So I just want you to know it means so much to me that you could be here tonight. Because I wanted you to be the first to know that I got tenure!
What?
You heard me. I got tenure.
suppose some congratulations are in order.
They are.
You know, I could really use a glass of water.
Congratulations, you're on the track.
On the strip, more like it. 10-year hoe stroke, you could say.
The 10-year hoe stroke, so to speak.
Well, you know, I am thrilled about it, right? Oh, I was starting to get to that place, right? I was walking around, I was singing that old Clash song.
Should I stay or should I go?
Still no seats where that child goes.
She'll be around, so you say.
Oh, hey, how's your book?
Oh, that's the other thing I wanted to tell you. I had a breakthrough. Now you know how for the longest time I've been going back and forth, about what to commit myself to as far as a manuscript. Then it hit me. My book, it is an intrepid look.
Have they put that in writing? Your book.
Well, of course.
I mean, not yet, but they certainly will.
I expect.
Because you know I've heard stories about people. Stories about scholars enticed by the book deal. They dangle the book deal in front of you and then no book.
Did you actually hear stories about that, or are you just saying?
Ibrahim Dale wrote an entire brilliant manuscript about his first generation blackness. They dangled the book deal and said that if, and only if, he changed the book dramatically, made the changes they thought he should make. So he did it. He changed the book. And then, after he made all those changes, you know what happened?
I bet it was the worst possible scenario, right?
They would publish it. Brother spent a year and a half rewriting what had already taken him 5 years to research and write. Mm.
Well, that is too bad for Ibrahim Dale. But in my book,
sure it is, I'm just saying.
Well, what does this have to do with me specifically?
I'm just saying, don't go drinking the Kool-Aid too fast.
Oh, I don't drink anybody's Kool-Aid.
Right. Or eat their watermelon.
Right. Or eat their chicken.
Right. Maybe grilled.
Not grilled, not whole, right?
Right. Right. Oh, you know, speaking of Kool-Aid and chicken.
Stop, this is part of it.
What do you call this? Punishment dining? Endurance cuisine? They just starve you to the brink until whatever they bring you will taste amazingly good.
Rochelle, please.
That girl better come on. That seed was salty and I need some water.
We are crystal clear about how you feel about this. Now back to my book.
Who's blurring the back?
Oh, I haven't thought of that yet.
Stop lying.
I just finished the first draft.
Damn, I thought you just came
up. Ooh, my hands were on fire. I was being guided by the ancestors.
You got a title?
No.
The Colon, the static life of two black dots.
Cute.
Coming of age in the Obama age. Ruminations on our new black millennial age of global enlightenment. And oh, by the way, Obama.
Oh, well, you look like the regular Cat Williams today.
You know that the book is a form of death?
Yes, I do, but I like to think of them more like bricks, right? Each book is like a brick,
like when you miss a jump shot.
Bricks with which I will build my structure.
Well, what kind? Or perhaps the bigger question is, for whom?
Well, let me see.
Me, of course.
I suppose you could come too, right?
And Martin
Lawrence. What's that? Oh, I am not just trying to be writing book after book after book to keep my name in people's mouths.
Oh, like Dyson?
I write books like Nigga Make Hooks.
I want to craft a classic. A Souls of Black Folks. Say,
waiting to expand.
I am going to the restroom, funny girl.
Hey, if you happen to see Miss Georgia, could you ask her if we could at least have a couple of sacks of flour to rest our weary Negro butts upon.
Holy shit!
Oh, I don't mean to be a snoop, but I overheard there were some congratulations going on.
Holy mother, damn, you scared me.
Oh, sorry. Would you like a glass of water?
Yeah, some water would be nice.
I'll see you later.
And how about some chairs?
So you're celebrating, huh? Are you pregnant?
What? No.
Oh. Is it your birthday?
No, my friend Anne got tenure.
Oh, well, that's a big deal, isn't it?
It's an endgame, for sure.
Oh, endgame.
For what we do, we're thinkers.
Oh, what do you think of?
Ideas. Complications. Issues.
Oh, you teach too at the college?
At the university.
The U or the state U?
The state U.
Oh. I hear they have really great bleachers.
I wouldn't know.
Do you teach diversity studies like Anne?
Anne doesn't teach diversity studies.
Oh, do you?
No, I teach African American literature and rhetoric.
Like Ebonics.
No, not African American rhetoric, just rhetoric.
Sound rag. He split himself up
we are not there yet. Where are we?
Black America. Currently Black America.
Presently Black America.
Right.
But we have a consciousness of white America.
And post-Black America, which we fear.
Fear of post-Black America.
We need presently Black North America.
For what?
To work. To play. To identify ourselves, really.
Well, what about white North America?
White North America is
just
like
white North America.
Like no just, white North America. That would be like
like concert footage of Sly and the Family Stone.
Boom! That goes to Anne.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, how about a fork?
Oh, you can go anywhere for a fork. Applebee's has four.
Oh my God.
And who wants the chair?
This is ridiculous.
This is so good.
I can't believe you're just with your hand.
Hey, wouldn't that taste even better? Sitting in your own chair.
You need to look at Green's piece again. For no other reason, to understand the current discourse.
I'm not doing this.
More chair for me.
As I was saying, just because I'm not doing this, does not mean that I don't understand, because, oh, I understand. It is because I understand. Because I so fully understand, I would rather watch Dolomite. I would be glad to open up any discourse about the perverse comedy of one Rudy Ray Moore. It's not current discourse. I get it. Am I a dentist or a black dentist? It's as old as hip-hop and capitalism. What I'm trying to say is, the only thing I'm trying to say is that we, and by we, I mean black folk of all shades and hair qualities, we avoid unpacking this obvious miscegenated moment in which we've arrived. After Rude Players Ball, Barack Obama in the miscegenated soul train line. Is that really all you're trying to say?
And
the New Yorker featured Kareem Peter Sound Blanket.
You liked it.
Good for you. Good for him. Good for his mom. I'm sure she's very proud. Good for your date. But I am not your date. Notice how I didn't say your white date. I am exercising a third consciousness.
Ooh, nice.
Wait for Russia.
I am starting to warm up to this place.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Smarter than you.
Think so?
He is. That's why he's always a pro.
No, no.
Oh, come on.
Just poking fun. I liked being there around the kids. It meant a lot to my niece.
What kind of school does your niece attend?
One of those urban charter schools with an indoor spice garden.
Right.
All the teachers look like these ex-suicide girls. It's all tattooed and dreaded. Heroes from flight and song. He worked with the hollowed walls to preserve our legacy. We are making history every day along this night.
It didn't rhyme.
Yeah? So? What was that one about again?
So join the troop?
You heard me say he. Stop playing. Come on.
Mm-mm.
Carter G. Woodson?
Oh.
You mean the father of Black History Month?
The very same.
Adorable.
Okay.
Do you ever engage them in any critical discourse around Black History Month?
What do you mean?
I mean, get them to look past the frivolity of the way in which Black history is
ghettoized
from the luxury condo that is American history?
No. Because it's elementary school.
Well, I know that, Michelle. I know. I just happen to think that there is room.
Someday, but right now they just need to at least know the names.
I think, just as an exercise, that you craft a poem in the voice of Carter G in that modern pseudo post-racial context, telling the kids, and this is just an idea, that he rejects the notion of a month, and then maybe you can add a joke in there. They gonna give us the shortest cold this month. That's an old Chris Rock joke.
Second of all, Black History Month is in the month of February. February is the month of Frederick Douglass's birthday.
I know that. This idea is just...
Look, I just like reading poems about Black people kids, okay?
All right, okay, fine. Michelle is for the children. I can tag say
it. Well, ODB went on it.
Yes, I wrote my dissertation on it.
Right. Of course, I remember. You mentioned that. How about another poem?
Hey!
I think it has been made perfectly clear who that teacher is at this table and who isn't.
Would you just stop your crying?
So rude.
Oh, don't be so sensitive. I liked your poem.
I liked your poem.
Is that the kind of lazy feedback they pass off as critical insight over there at the liberal arts college?
All right, now slow your roll.
I mean, do you even teach, honestly, or do you just, I don't know, publish and drink lots?
I lead a team of research assistants.
Please.
I coordinate their classrooms, their curriculum,
hey,
their courses.
You there, yes, you! Fetch me articles on Sunhouse, Black Lightning, and Moms Bagley. And you there, girl, I will require fresh
symbiosis. I give lectures, I publish, I view.
You
gently
wander the clouds gently flowing until the muse freshens your sniffer of absence.
Let me go and flag down our server. Perhaps we can order something to stop your crying.
Shut up and eat your salad crumbs. And our server's name is George.
about it, all right?
Well, sit down.
Huh? We'll get fed and all will be made.
It's not even about food anymore. It's about you.
Me? Acting all high and... Who do you think you are? Talking about some courage, Woodson. The man is to be revered.
I wasn't trying to diss him. I was just saying that he knew, all right? Carter G. knew that one day his invention would be a pointless exercise.
I don't think he said that.
Maybe not in those terms, but didn't he say something along the lines of hopefully we won't need a separate one?
Did you know that some of my freshmen, now these are college kids I'm talking to, they think that the Civil War started with a bus boycott. They think that General E. Lee gave the I Have a Dream speech. So that's why we need it. 1 month is better than no month at all.
I see. That. That right there is what I wrestle with. Better than nothing? How easily we settle.
We're either settled or we go mad.
Many of us are mad.
What are you ever mad about? You're all set up.
My brother is certainly mad.
The marginalized settle is what the marginalized
do. It is just history, Rochelle. No black, no Latino, no women.
Oh,
no,
I know.
You know. Yeah, you participate in Black History Month. You are fanning the flames of 28 days of God. You cannot just... This is what's holding you back.
The equivalent of world music.
reject your tenure status in solidarity?
We don't work at the same institutions.
It doesn't matter. We're a small city. All us educators are one community. It would reverberate.
Here alone, so I would like to sit alone.
She is just being.
You don't know what I'm being.
What are you prepared to offer?
What would you like?
What qualifies you for a table?
Honey, and here. Pretty impressive.
That's right.
Honey, she knows it all.
Well, yes, but I know what she knows.
I know you know what I know, but did you know that I also know Tolstoy and Shostakovich, Mozart and Bergman, Fellini, Whitman and Beckett, Joyce Carol Oates, Flannery O'Connor?
I know you know what I know, but did you know that I also know Kubrick, Hitchcock and Chandler, Salinger, Selznick and Lloyd Wright?
Lloyd Webber. I know you know what I know, but did you know
I
that
know.
I also know
just like
Einstein
everybody,
and
these
Uber,
tenants, we are
Hugo,
surrounded.
Shockley, Shakespeare,
Voltaire, Rimbaud, Chaucer.
Yes,
Lyons.
We are surrounded by canons. I know you know what I know.
We are
but
surrounded
you know
by canons.
Wow.
I know.
Carwell, Burroughs, Griffin.
Shaw, Emerson, Byron, Foster, Wallace, Cagney, Bogart, Barrymore.
I know you know what I know, but did you know that I also know Kerouac?
I know.
Roy,
I know.
Sophocles.
He has a dog.
I know you know what I know, but did you know that I also know Van Gogh, Van
Hero,
I am
and surrounded.
Van Fleet,
Van Fleck,
Van
Dyke,
Van
Trelin. All right, now you're just cherry picking.
Don't hate.
Nice point for a shell. No more swagger. You just lost. I got the table, and you got tossed.
I got the table. I got the table.
Wait, now why does she get a tablecloth?
Come on.
Hey, Georgia, you like music?
The other patron over there is disturbing me.
Certainly.
to the Kentucky Derby. I liked learning where the salad fork goes now.
I eat salad with my hands, but my brother was learning from the drugstores. In my new book, I chronicle my brother's rise and fall. In my book, I am examining how to give a brother, a sister, a privileged couple of kids.
She fought, but she hit a ceiling. The university said we not feeling.
You.
She was like, BAM!
That was kind of whack.
Staff hate. Awesome job, Rochelle.
Science.
be told, right? It's a good story.
Yes, they'll probably make a movie out of it like they did with that Anton Fisher.
Right, but I think it was Ed
Twan, though.
But you feel like you're exploitationing your brother.
Kinda. Yes.